As we continue this special health edition of The Balancing Act, we're going behind the mystery. Today, the ultra-rare disease known as congenital plasminogen deficiency. Now, while few are affected, it has a profound impact on sufferers, their families, and society. Put on the medical map 170 years ago, it is only now that patients are seeing hope, new treatments are on the horizon. Joining me to talk about this systemic and potentially life-threatening illness are Dr. Shira Robbins from Shiley Eye Institute, University of California, San Diego, and a young warrior, Andrea, who's affected by this disease almost since birth, and her mother, Jessica, a formidable plasminogen deficiency advocate. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Doctor, let me start with you, and I'm going to be completely honest. Plasminogen deficiency, I had never heard of it.
You are not alone, Olga.
Okay, good.
Plasminogen deficiency is a rare, potentially lethal, and blinding disease. And it happens because patients lack the enzyme called plasminogen. Mm-hmm. And that enzyme is supposed to take away certain proteins. So what happens is we get these protein buildup throughout our body, which lays down in layers, which form these thick membranes all throughout our body. And in my work at the Shiley Eye Institute, I like to explain things in terms of everyday life. So if you were to take your front lawn and imagine that you never weeded or mowed again, which I know you would never do, mm-hmm. all of your healthy plants would end up getting choked and eventually die. And that's what happens in this disease process.
That's a great analogy. Thank you for that, Doctor. Jessica, Andrea, let me bring you in. Tell me about your journey with plasminogen deficiency. When did you notice that your daughter had it, Jessica?
Well, I've always kind of noticed
you
since
have?
She was born.
What happened?
She's had many bouts of what they've always thought was pink eye.
Which Andrea's a lot of kids been, have.
Right? Exactly. So Andrea's been treated for pink eye, the normal regimen of what they would give for pink eye many times. Mm-hmm. It got to a point where it wasn't going away, and we were referred finally to the Children's Hospital in Chicago after many visits back and forth between her pediatrician and ophthalmology. Misdiagnosed, she was finally diagnosed when she was about almost four.
4 years later.
But even then, we've done so many experimental treatments because there wasn't anything available at that time.
What a nightmare. Andrea, I know you were quite young, but do you have any recollection? Do you remember? How did it affect you?
It affected me not as much as it affected my family, mm-hmm. but that's only because I was young and I didn't know much of what was going on. I just knew that there was something wrong.
Doctor, is this typical of those affected with plasminogen deficiency?
It is. It's very typical, having to go through many, many doctors and oftentimes many years and sometimes even having many surgeries before the proper diagnosis is made. And it only takes a simple blood test.
A blood test.
Mm-hmm.
To get a diagnosis.
To get the diagnosis.
All right, so let's kind of create some awareness here today. And what are the signs and symptoms to look out for here?
Well, the signs and symptoms are created by these membranes that I mentioned earlier, and they can happen in multiple organ systems throughout the body, mm-hmm. usually where we have mucous membranes, which are the wet portions of the inner sides of our bodies. So when it happens in the eyes, these membranes occur on the inner sides of our eyelids, and it can lead to scarring and even blindness. It leads to a lot of tearing, some pain, and it really changes someone's appearance. It can take away hearing when it affects the ears. In the mouth, patients lose teeth, and in the airways, oftentimes those patients have respiratory distress, and they can even die from that. It can change the fluid channels inside of the brain, leading to swelling of the brain.
Oh my goodness.
Kidney failure, infertility, skin rashes, and very poor wound healing. So it really affects a lot of parts of the body.
So if it affects a lot of parts of the bodies, mm-hmm. We're talking about then probably you going to a pulmonologist, a rheumatologist, an ophthalmologist, a specialist after specialist? Is that what you did?
Yes. Yeah. She sees many specialists. She's goes to ENT, she has an ophthalmologist, her pediatrician, her hematologist, an ENT for ears, nose, and throat.
And doctor, that is so trying.
It does. It takes a team of doctors to not only diagnose this, but also to treat it. And it can occur, usually in infancy, the beginning, but it can occur for the first time in terms of symptoms at any time in the lifetime.
So what treatment options are available today?
Well, originally, people saw these membranes and they wanted to peel them, both the doctors as well as the parents. But that really doesn't help. In fact, it can make it worse, because when those membranes are peeled, oftentimes they grow back very quickly and even thicker than before. So there's been a host of treatments which have been tried, and unfortunately none of them work great. It makes the most sense to try and replace what is deficient, so to replace the plasminogen in the first place. Right now, there is no current FDA-approved plasminogen replacement therapy. But there is one which is currently being reviewed by the FDA. Mm. And so what that means is that all the scientific analysis isn't complete, but it's in the works. And Andrea has actually been a part of that, an important part of that, participating in that clinical trial.
And now that you have participated in this clinical trial, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling way better health-wise. I mean, physically and emotionally, mentally, just everything.
That is great.
It feels great.
Oh, and you look beautiful and you sound great, and it makes me happy to know that. I know you're probably the happiest mom today to see her so much better, but the road has not been easy, has it?
No. Andrea had FM systems in class for her moderate hearing loss. She's had preferential seating in class because of her vision loss. So she's felt kind of singled out her whole life. She was bullied a lot in elementary school because her eyes were crossed, because her brain had shut down her right eye. So we've dealt with a lot of those things.
I know you have a lot of hope, and you are an advocate for Andrea and anyone with plasminogen deficiency. What resources are out there for families today, if you can offer any?
The biggest resource that I have is a Facebook page that I created in desperation to find other people.
Good for you.
Because when I first had Andrea diagnosed, I had nobody, and I was told that there was nobody. So I'd created this Facebook page, and people have found me. It's called Ligneous Conjunctivitis and Plasminogen Deficiency Support Group. And we all talk to each other, moms, caregivers, patients.
Create awareness.
Yes. Cry on each other's shoulders, share our successes.
Doctor, what advice would you give to someone out there who may be going through this right now or may have the symptoms and signs?
Well, I think that it requires a strong and supportive family unit, but I'm very hopeful for the future of these patients. We have great educational things happening, like this show today. Mm-hmm. We have another very promising treatment right around the corner. So I'm very hopeful that in the future, patients identified with this disease process will be able to do the simple things that we all take for granted, like taking a deep breath, mm-hmm. seeing your best friend, listening to your favorite music, and maybe even becoming a parent.
And Andrea, I want to end with you. Any final words?
I just want other patients to understand that they need to have self-confidence and they need to not care what other people think about them, because you're you, and that's just everything.
And you are amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming today, Andrea. Good luck to you. Jessica, thank you, and for being such a great mom, and for talking to others about this. Doctor, for the insight, thank you so much. It's critical to identify the symptoms early and get tested for a plasminogen deficiency. A simple blood test can make a significant difference in the disease management. For more information, medical education for that matter, you can go to plasminogen.com, or for patient information, you can go to pts.plasminogen.com, or you can always just go to our website, thebalancingact.com.